So now I'm going to use the same previous example of filling a tank and mixing the liquid, but instead I'm going to use a latch and unlatch instructions. Again, the example was there's a start push button to start and a filling valve opens to start filling the tank with the liquid. Once the liquid reaches a certain point, the valve closes and the mixer starts mixing until we press on the stop push button. So here we have three inputs and two outputs, and again, they're all normally open contacts. So this is what we did, and once the start push button is pressed, the valve is open and start filling. And as soon as you let go, the valve closes. So in order to keep the valve open, previously, we used a sealing instruction or holding instruction to keep the output on. This time, we are going to use a latch instruction. Remember, latch instruction is an output instruction used to maintain or latch an output even if the input condition changes. Any rung that has a latching instruction, this means that the output reference to the latching instruction is turned on and stays on. Keep in mind that the latch output stays latch unless I use an unlatch instruction. Now going back to the problem, once the liquid reaches a set point, the level sensor is activated and the valve closes. So I need the level sensor to be active. I can use it for the unlatch instruction to unlatch the valve. Remember that latch and unlatch work in pair and must have the same address. So now the program works this way. Once the start push button is pressed, the valve opens and starts filling the tank with the liquid. Once the liquid reaches a certain level, the level sensor is activated and the unlatch instruction will be turned on or highlighted and the valve will close. The other thing that happens when the level sensor is on is that the mixer starts mixing. So I add the level sensor as an XIC to the mixer. So the program now works this way. As soon as the liquid reaches the desired level, the valve stops and the mixer starts. And this is how the program looks like so far. Once the start push button is pressed, the valve opens and it is latched, so it stays on. And the tanks start filling with the liquid. Once the liquid reaches the certain level, the level sensor is activated and the unlatch instruction will be highlighted in order to close the valve. And in the same time, the mixer starts mixing. Note here that the level sensor activates two outputs. It activates the filling valve, the unlatch instruction, and it activates the mixer. So since I have multiple outputs to the same input, I can add them in parallel. So now as soon as the level sensor is on, it activates both outputs, the valve is unlatched, and the mixer is on. The last thing is that the mixer stops when the push button is pressed. Again, remember that it's a normally open contact. So I need to think about where to put the stop push button. The stop push button is going to be added to this rung because I want the mixer to stop once I press on the stop push button. Again, since we're using a normally open contact, we are going to use examine if open instruction XIO. So now the program looks this way. Since it's a normally open contact, we are going to use an XIO instruction for the stop push button. Once the level sensor is activated or is active, the filling valve is unlatched and the mixer turns on. As soon as the stop push button is pressed, the instruction is not activated anymore and the mixer stops. So this is how the complete program looks like using a latch and unlatch. It does the same thing as the previous example. The only difference is that we're using a latch and unlatch instruction instead of using a hold in or a seal in instructions. And using the simulation software, you can see that once you press on the start push button, it latches the output, the valve is open. Once we reach the level sensor, now it unlatches the valve and the mixer starts mixing. And notice here that once we press on the stop push button, this stops the whole thing.